Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today we're going to be talking about performance modifications and upgrades for the 4.3 liter EcoTec3 engine that was used in the 2014 plus Silverado and Sierra 1500s. The 4.3 EcoTec3 came from the factory with 285 horsepower and 305 torque, but most models are flex fuel capable, which can add some additional horsepower, which we'll go ahead and talk about a little bit more later. Now, the 4.3 EcoTec3 is of course a V6 engine and it is naturally aspirated. And so it is not necessarily stacked with performance potential from the factory, especially when you compare it to the upgraded 5.3 and 6.2 liter V8s that were an option on the Silverado and Sierra 1500s. But fortunately, there are a few basic bolt-on modifications that you can do to the 4.3s to go ahead and add a pretty decent amount of horsepower. So today we're going to be covering what I'm going to consider basic bolt-on modifications. All of these modifications can add about 50 wheel horsepower to your 4.3 liter EcoTec engine. Now, those are pretty solid power gains for just bolt-on modifications. There are some things that you can do to take things a notch beyond that, like camshaft upgrades and forced induction, but those are a lot more advanced. There's a lot more considerations that go into it. And at that point, you're talking about spending a pretty significant amount of money on your truck to where a lot of people are probably just going to tell you to go ahead and upgrade to a V8 at that time. So we're just going to focus on the basic bolt-on modifications here, and then we'll save any of the more advanced modifications for a different video down the line. So the first and the best upgrade for a 4.3 Silverado or Sierra is going to be engine tuning. Just completely stock with no other modifications, engine tuning can add about 10 to 15 wheel horsepower and 15 to 20 wheel torque to your truck. However, there are some benefits to running tuning alongside an intake and an exhaust, and especially alongside E85 fueling. E85 fueling will automatically give you power increases, and running that with a specific custom E85 tune will be able to open things up and get you closer to about 25 wheel horsepower and 30 to 35 wheel torque gains from tuning. And so ultimately, getting custom tuning, even more specifically, custom tuning made for E85 fueling, is going to be the best modification and the biggest power gains that you can get on the 4.3 liter engine. It's typically going to run you anywhere from $700 to $1,000 to get all of the hardware and the custom tuning software that you need to be able to do this to your truck. So it is one of the more expensive things, but it has the best power gains out of anything on our list and is the kind of building block or platform for all of the other upgrades that we're going to talk about here. The second thing is going to be upgrading the exhaust system. The headers are actually one of the most restrictive parts within the exhaust system on these 4.3 engines. So getting a good set of headers is gonna offer you some pretty good power gains and is gonna be the best exhaust modification. Now, overall, your best bet's gonna be upgrading the full exhaust system, but that's gonna either include you getting long tube headers, which will delete the catalytic converter, and then getting a cat back, or if you wanna keep your truck emissions compliant, you're gonna need shorty headers, a high flow catalytic converter, and then a cat-back portion of the exhaust system, which does get a little bit expensive, but ultimately doing a full exhaust upgrade is where you're gonna see your biggest power gains and likely be able to see somewhere from about 10 to 15 wheel horsepower when combined with tuning. Ultimately, if you don't have the budget for a full exhaust system, the headers are gonna be the most important part. Long tube headers are gonna be better from a performance standpoint, but short tube headers are going to keep you emissions compliant without getting rid of your factory catalytic converter. The third upgrade on our list is a cold air intake. A cold air intake by itself doesn't really offer too much in the way of performance gains, but when we combine an intake with tuning and with an exhaust system, there are some benefits to it that make it worthwhile to upgrade. So a cold air intake is gonna be my third recommendation on this list. It's just gonna help bring a little bit extra air to the engine to help improve the efficiency of the engine. Ultimately, in any engine, the faster you can get air in and the faster you can get air out, the more efficient your engine's gonna be and therefore the more power that it's gonna make. And so that's the reasoning for wanting a cold air intake on these engines. Just be careful what kind of cold air intake you put on here. You don't want one that is open to the engine bay and sucking in all of the hot air. And then the last modification on this list is E85 fueling. As I mentioned, most of these trucks are flex fuel capable, which means that you can run ethanol fuels, and ethanol fuels burn at a higher octane rating than your typical 87, 91, or 93 pump gas, and so they naturally produce more power. GM even quotes that if you use flex fuel or full E85 on your 4.3 liter, it will improve the power levels from 285 horsepower to 297 horsepower, and from 305 torque to 330 torque. You'll get 12 horsepower and 25 torque gains just from running E85 without adding any sort of tuning or other modifications to your truck. So when we take E85 and combine it with tuning and with these other modifications, you end up getting really good power gains out of it. The caveat to E85, especially when you talk about using E85 with custom tuning, you're probably gonna see somewhere around 20 to 30% fuel economy decreases, but the one good thing for that is if you've ever taken a look at E85 fuel, E85 fuel is a good bit cheaper than the lowest 87 octane rating. And so you do make up for some of that decreased fuel economy just in the decreased cost of E85 gasoline. All of this to say too, if you are wanting to maximize the performance of your 4.3 Silverado or Sierra, you're gonna want to run higher than 85 or 87 octane anyways. Any sort of custom tuning that you can do to maximize the performance potential from the tuning, you're gonna wanna be running 91 or 93 octane anyways. Getting an 87 octane or 85 octane tune isn't gonna be that great, since you're gonna need some of those higher octane levels to be able to really get the best benefit from tuning. So for that reason, running full E85 with a custom E85 tune is gonna hands down be the best modification that you can do from a performance and power standpoint on these engines. So that covers it for the four best modifications on this list. Tuning is going to be one of the more expensive things depending on the exhaust setup that you go for, but with tuning costing $700 to $1,000, an intake being around $300, and then an exhaust system setup, depending on whether you go with just headers or headers and a full exhaust system, ultimately you can be into all of these modifications for somewhere around $2,000. And you should be able to add about 50 wheel horsepower, which is pretty good power gains for that money and a pretty meaningful amount of power for this 4.3 liter V6 engine. As I mentioned earlier, starting to push past and get bigger power gains than that is gonna require a lot more advanced modifications. Those are things that we could argue whether or not it's worth it to do it on a V6 truck, but of course people do it. There are camshaft upgrades out there. There are turbo kits that you can throw on there. So those are some of the things that you'll want to start looking into if you're sticking with your V6 and you want to add more than 50 wheel horsepower. Anyways, guys, that covers it for our guide on performance upgrades and bolt-on modifications for the 4.3 liter EcoTec3. If you guys appreciate this content, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for all of the future GM content we have coming.